Morning, sweetheart. Here we are again on the Roddy Records show. I'm excited today.
You are?
Well, you know, we were very successful. I thought I loved the car songs.
Right.
So, of course, I got excited and started thinking about something similar, and I came up with train songs.
Well, and train. There's also a group called Train.
Oh, you're right. I didn't record any of their songs.
Oh, but you didn't either on the car one either.
Well, that's right. That we're trying to find songs that have the titles of the cars and the trains. So,
right.
Yeah, you're right. So we didn't have to do that. But, you know, I've always thought as trains of kind of a romantic thing. You know, back in the day, and I had to go back and look at movies in the 30s and the 40s, people took trains everywhere.
Yes.
And I'm not talking about the trains of today, the subways where there's issues and about the trains where they...
Have you ever been on a train?
Oh, I mean, traveling? Yeah.
So have I, when I was a little girl.
Yeah.
My dad worked in Fresno, and my mom and Lauren and I would get on the train and go to Fresno.
You know, it's funny because, you know, in the day, my grandmother used to show up in Salinas from Vacaville. Somehow she found a train to get here. That was a mode of transportation. I got on a train to go to San Francisco as a kid to visit my Aunt Winoma and Uncle Carol in San Francisco. So trains were a very valid...
Okay, let's hear some music about trains.
Well, okay, so...
I'm cutting you off.
You are cutting me off. You always cut me off, whether we're doing this or during the day. All right, Ron, you know, get around to it. So, right?
Yeah. What?
I don't know why you're laughing like that, but just come on, let's move on. You want to hear a song, a train song?
This Karen, is probably
focus, train song.
This is probably the most famous train song.
To you, it's a song out of the 70s.
Well, I mean, is there anything else?
Well, yes, there is. Love Train by the OJs. This is the era. Would you stop and get control of yourself?
All right, hurry up.
Professional. We're professionals here. Oh, help me, somebody. Anyway, this was the time of everybody's on board with love and kind of the hippie thing, you know, love. We love everybody. We love it. It's cool because I wish today everybody was on the love train.
Yeah.
So a great sentiment. We're talking 40 plus years ago. We had that wonderful movement. Everybody's going to love each other. We're all going to get along and see us today. Oh, my God.
All right. Well, this is a good one. All right.
All right.
Is this a one-hit wonder for them?
Oh, no, they have a few other hits. Okay. Love Roller Coaster was another one. Come on, Roller Coaster.
There you go. All right, good.
All right, so the next one,
well,
you know this one, too.
I probably know this one, too, because I like it. Yes, this is another famous one.
You and see this build up like the train's going?
And speaking of that, my brother was in a musical, and he did a lot of musicals back in the day, and he was in the back of the train with three other guys, and they were doing this, and when you were in the audience, you actually thought he was on a train.
You're on a train.
Yes.
That's right.
Yes, Lauren was a
was
great actor.
On
so
Broadway,
was Robin.
Broadway, right?
A little off Broadway.
A little off.
Lauren and Robin.
Off Broadway? Okay.
They were both great actors.
All right, so Long Trainer running by...
Oh, the Doobie Brothers,
the Doobie Brothers, and our son Randy loves the Doobies.
Yes.
Well, he loves the Doobies with Michael McDonald. This is not
Michael McDonald is a good-looking guy.
Oh, here we go again. Anyway, yeah, this is before Michael McDonald joined the group. Long Train of Running. I think it was their first hit, but I'm not sure. They were a group out of San Jose.
All right. See,
local
California
group.
California groups.
California group, and I think they're still going around performing.
Okay.
With or without Michael, I don't know.
Nice.
So next, another famous... I think 60s, 70s song. I'm not quite sure what year this was. Gladys Knight and the Pimps.
Oh, yeah.
You always recognize the song when I play them.
Name that song in three tunes.
Long Train to Red, no. Midnight Train to Georgia.
Yeah. She was good.
Yeah.
I love this kind of music. I do too. I like this.
Gladys Knight and the Pips, yeah. That was her group behind her.
Yeah.
They had a lot of hits back in the day. You got a great tune, and you've got it going with that train.
Know,
look
right?
at you, you're caught with that train.
I know. Lauren taught me well.
Right. So right. The next train song is by James Brown. And I love James Brown's performer. I mean, he's a wild man on the stage. Night Train was done by like an instrumental back in the 40s. There's a zillion people have done Night Train. But I gotta love this version of James Brown. You can just see him.
All aboard! The Night Train.
Right? Here we go on the Night Train. James Brown.
Right?
Miami, Florida.
I like James Brown.
See, they're calling up the cities where the train's
right.
going. You know, you can just see that porter. All right.
All right, here we are. Memphis.
Memphis, whatever. Yeah. Hear that? Night Train. This is a classic out of the 40s, 50s.
Were there a lot of groups that took the train?
A lot of versions of this song.
No. Were there a lot of groups that took the train, or did they take a bus? We know about the airplanes, but did they take trains?
Yeah, mostly buses. And a lot of course, more recently, that's 30, 40 years, they had their own big RV.
Right.
But
you could live in them.
But yeah, they probably took the train. It's a slower way
to get there,
but I'm sure in the day they did. But anyway, this is James Brown. A lot of versions of this song.
Yeah.
The next one is Last Train to Memphis by Johnny Rivers, and I'm a big fan. Now, you see this book here. Last Train to Memphis is about the early rise of Elvis Presley, who we did two episodes on Elvis,
right.
One about the movie and one about Elvis in general. But this is probably not a well-known version of Johnny Rivers sang. And there's another version of two different songs, Last Train to Memphis, that are really aimed at Elvis. This one, I think, is really about Elvis growing up and going to Memphis and how it eventually becomes a star. I'm not sure.
Okay.
Nice song, though. Listen to this. Last Train to Memphis.
I don't know this one.
No, it's not. I don't know if it was ever a hit, but it's on an album.
I don't even know him.
It's on an album. Yeah, well, we saw him in Reno. Johnny Rivers had all those great songs in the 70s.
Yeah. All right.
But no, don't move on. Listen to it a little bit. Got a nice little kind of a country sound. But it's I think it's about Elvis and his mother and father going to Memphis.
Okay.
You have a chance. Pull it up. I'm sure there's a YouTube version of this song by Johnny Rivers. Nice song. I think it's about Elvis. This is a great biography of Elvis in the early years. Whoa.
All right.
Sorry, Elvis. This
That's
is the early song in the 50s by Johnny Burnett, who had a lot of hits. And this is The Train Kept a Running.
Yeah. Woo, fast
train. Train Kept a Running.
Don't know that one.
Well, you'll be familiar with the next few songs. Remember how much I love Annette and that violoncello.
And her little Mickey Mouse.
Well,
ears.
She was. She also had a lot of the bikini beach parties. Come on.
And who was the guy she was always with?
Oh, Frankie Avalon was always her co-star.
All right, let's hear Annette.
Got a nice little
and
pop song.
I think we would be able to dance to this.
Yeah, you're right.
I mean, probably not as fast, but we could slow it down.
Yeah, so this is the train of love. It's a nice little beat. Nice pop song. She was, remember, she was on the Mickey Mouse Club. And Walt started recording some of her songs.
Right.
And then she got in the Beach Blanket movie. She was the only one that wore a one-piece swimsuit. Walt did not want her wearing a bikini. You know, those days the bikinis were big. They weren't these little teeny-weeny bikinis. But it's a nice little pop song.
Yeah, it is.
By Annette.
Okay.
I think we might have played the next song because it was one of my favorite songs by Cher, Train of Thought. Listen to the train?
Yeah, I did.
Feel that train moving? This is Cher, Train of Thought.
I would not have known the title.
You hear that voice?
Like
that,
yeah,
voice?
That voice
is so distinctive.
Yeah.
Again.
Yeah. Even today, she's still looking and can sing. Yeah.
Well, I think she's 100 years old. They probably prop
her
up
now.
She's
not. No, I just saw her the other day on TV. She looked good. Yeah.
I'm sorry, I'm still moving to this song.
I know you are.
Not a big hit for her, but what a great song.
It's a good song.
Train of Thought, and our last song.
All right.
This is all doo-wop, honey. You won't
are
know
we
it.
Are really loud this morning?
I just feel with it this morning. We're going to play the music loud and talk loud and be loud.
Okay.
Just like a train coming down that track.
Doo-doo,
so the next song is The Woo Woo Train. It's all doo-wop. You're going to go, oh,
I'm
going to
love
it. Turn it off.
Turn
it off. This
I'm not going to say turn off doo-wop.
Oh, no. This is straight doo-wop. This is old-time doo-wop.
All right. Let me hear it.
By the Valentine's. Let's see the train again. All aboard.
All aboard.
This is doo-wop.
This is bubblegum.
No, this is real authentic doo-wop. Listen, blah, blah, blue. This is old-fashioned doo-wop.
I like the later doo-wop.
I know you do.
I do.
I just had to include it because it's the Woo Woo Train by the Valentine's. Not a big name group, not a big hit song. But I thought we'd close out with
Turn it down.
You keep telling me like you're my mother again. Turn it down. Anyway.
Someone has to control you.
That's
good.
Just a few of my train songs.
All right.
Got a lot of them.
That's good. And again, not one train song.
By train.
What are you talking
about?
But you know, I think our son and daughter-in-law like train.
Yes, I'm pretty sure Randy and Corby do. Yeah.
Yes, they do
like
train.
And I do too.
Yeah.
Good, more recent group. Probably don't have any hits today, but I call it recent.
Right.
Anyway.
But they like train.
Anyway, you know, everybody, I hope you enjoyed one more episode with Rod and Karen on the Roddy Records Show. We always enjoy them.
We do.
Again, I like to articulate. We do not study. I don't look up on the internet. This is just out of my collection.
You know, 5 minutes before we started this, we were talking about dental insurance.
Yeah.
So, I mean, we go from one to the other real fast. Okay,
Karen said, let's get going. Let's make an episode. So we just jump and sit down. We don't rehearse it. Just us and the music. So
anyway, it's been fun again.
Sure, be sure to subscribe to the Roddy Records Show. And just enjoy.
Yep. All right. Goodbye, friends. See you next time.
And you can't stroll to this record, Karen.